you know, who just finished up winning a national championship with the New Orleans Boosters. This is back-to-back national championships for you. And in 2021, you were the tournament MVP. Tell us a little bit about your experience in Johnstown and with the AAABA and
Shoot.
Your experience overall.
I would say, besides my senior year summer here, it was probably the funnest 2 years of summer baseball I've had. Just the tradition behind everything. I mean, New Orleans this year was the 76th year we've been up there. So, and it's like, it's what a lot of people consider real baseball. I mean, as we talked about earlier, if you lose, you go home. If not, you keep playing. But it was a very cool atmosphere. You're going to sign autographs. You're going to have random fans. Like, the city it's in just really loves New Orleans. And to actually be playing with the city of New Orleans across your chest is special by itself. But, yeah, to win two national championships back-to-back like that, and actually the New Orleans franchise three-peated for the first time since the 50s. So to do that and kind of set that mark, we set the stolen base record this year. So kind of just keep upping the tradition that, like, one every year is kind of fun to be a part of. So it was definitely something that was real special.
Was this year any more special than the previous year because you had three of your Titan classmates with you?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, it was the two teams were two totally different teams. This year, every game we were in was a tight game that we had to fight through adversity with. And kind of what you said, sharing those moments with three of the other people I've played with for so long was real special. I can remember the semifinals. We started the semifinals. I looked at Norris and I was like, let's try to win this semifinal, talking about how we lost the one my junior year. Me and Chris actually had a special moment before we pitched in the championship. You know, I just kind of walked up to him and just reminded him. I know how he gets sometimes. I just told him to take a deep breath. I said, bro, it's time to go. Like, we're playing for it finally. We're here. We might as well just take it all with us. And told him to calm down. And when he gets overwhelmed, look at me, stick out his tongue so he'd laugh, calm him down. So just the little things about knowing them for so long like that, and then actually winning right when we won. I didn't even run straight to the dog pile. There's a video of it. You can see me and Norris run across the second base and hug each other first and then go dog pile. So it was definitely something special to do with those guys for sure.
And do you think your experience at Lakeshore with your classmates helped you since you've graduated?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. If you just look at the amount of adversity the program faced while we were here the whole time, Coach Batt took over, and then he unfortunately had his stroke, and we didn't really have a head baseball coach for that whole baseball season. And then Coach Seravolo stepping in and doing what he did and kind of setting his foot down and saying, hey, we're going to do things like this. We're going to do it like this and only like this, and we're going to have some success. And that was the year he took us to the semifinals. And then losing the semifinals, obviously, put something in all three of us that we knew if we got back there, we weren't losing it again. So I would definitely say for sure it weighed on us a little bit.
And when you speak of the adversity in the coaching changes, kind of similar to the 2023 team, this is their third head coach since they've
right.
been to school. But it appears the program's not slowing down. What kind of leadership do you need from these seniors to stabilize with the new coaching and keep their eye on the prize to get that final out in Sulphur?
I would just say, look who's still around you, I guess. That was a big thing for us. No matter what happened with whoever was taking charge of us at the head, basically, we knew we had all, I think we had 12 of us in our senior class. So, I mean, I think knowing, like, no matter what, if you make a bad pitch or bad error, like, I got your back. And the same thing, like, outside of it. As long as you know, like, those people are there for you, and when it's time, those are the people that are going to win the game or actually lose the game. I think that's a big part of it.
You don't see too many coaches throwing strikes or getting base hits.
Right, exactly.
Right. Going back to your Titan days, tell me about a couple of your biggest moments.
Shoot. We had so many of them. I would say when we won the district championship here and got to dog pile against Pearl River for the first outright district championship here. It was a big moment. Olivier started. We wound up beating Pearl River 2-1. And I think me and Devin Wahlbacher were 5-6 that day. So to be that huge of an influence on the game and make a couple big plays in that game for us was huge. And for it to be a four district championship would be a feeling I'll never forget. The whole junior season, really. I mean, we won 27 in a row, I think. So, I mean, when you're hot like that, everybody's going to be happy and having fun. Making it to Sulphur for the first time. There's little things like that, just the locker room stories that still get brought up when you run into people, the bus rides. I mean, we stayed in Sulphur for a week in a hotel. I mean, I don't think any other team did that. So if we can put up with each other for that long, it shows how strong our bonds were with people. I think it was huge for us.
Let's talk about the 2023 Titans. Obviously, there's a lot of expectations, very similar to your class. What advice would you give this group, not only mentally, physically, but how to stay focused on that final out in Sulphur?
Remember the feeling when you lost. I know how hard it was for me when we lost my junior year. So I would say remember that feeling and slow the game down and know that your time's running out. I think all three of us will agree that our best times are playing with each other on this field right here. It's one of those things you learn when you're done playing. But soak it all in for sure and just make the most of it in every way possible. And just don't take it for granted and do it with pride and be the first people to ever do it, to be honest. I mean, hats off to y'all if y'all do it. We're all behind y'all. We're all pulling for you. So I would just keep your head down, go to work, and have that goal and do whatever it takes to accomplish it.
How important do you think it was for your class and the success you had for the non-traditional baseball summers that you guys spent together?
A lot. I mean, yeah, we didn't go, none of us played travel ball or anything. So, I mean, when you're around the same team, the same guys for that period of time, playing that many games together, I mean, you find a lot of things out about them, whether you like it or you hate it. But at the end of the day, when you know y'all are all truly there for the same goal 24/7, it definitely helps whether knowing who's going to show up to a summer game, who's not. I mean, it creates a trust throughout the team that like says, hey, we're pulling for all the same goal the whole year.
Fantastic. Christian Wescott,